Hey Jarvis, is the earth flat?
No, the earth is not flat. It's an oblate spheroid, which means it's mostly spherical, but slightly flattened at the poles and slightly bulging at the equator.
Hello, so in this video, we will learn how to use ChatGPT as a voice assistant in Home Assistant, using this device, the ESP Muse Luxe, as a streaming device. So it looks like a Bluetooth device, but inside you have an ESP32 device, which will be used to record your voice and to stream the result back to you from ChatGPT. So this device is available on Amazon and also on our website, raspiaudio.com. See the link in the description. So the first step will be to install the Home Assistant firmware on the ESP Muse Luxe device. To do so, you will need to go on this website, raspiaudio.github.io. You will see the link in the description. You select the Luxe device, then select Home Assistant. Then at the bottom of the page, you will see a button and you click on connect. Then you choose the right COM port, CP104, and using the USB port, you will upload the correct firmware on the device. You click on install ESP Home and click on install again. The whole process is going to take something like 2 minutes. So as soon as it started, I will pause the video and we will come back. So we are back 99%. So the next step, we will need to install the Wi-Fi. So to install the Wi-Fi, click on next, select your Wi-Fi network SSID and type in your password. Click on connect. Then you're connected to the network. You click on continue. And then you will go back to Home Assistant and click on Settings, Device and Services. And you will see your ESP Muse Luxe device discovered. You click on Configure. Yes, Submit. Select an area, it doesn't matter. Finish. Then click on Device. And you will see your ESP Muse Luxe here. Sometimes you have more info on sensor, but click on dashboard anyway. And add on dashboard. Go back on settings. So now you need to install the Open API conversation. So just Google this or just click in the link in my description and add integration to Home Assistant. It will open a new page. You need to accept to install this extension and set up Home Assistant conversation. Then you need your API key from OpenAI. So if you haven't done it yet, you will need an OpenAI account, and this is basically an billable services, sorry. So you will need to open your OpenAI page, OpenAI, sorry, and you generate a key. you copy this key and you paste it in the OpenAI conversation in Home Assistant. Then you created successfully this service. Then you click on Settings. Then you need to set up a voice assistant. Okay, so then you click on Add an Assistant. You give a name to it. GPT, for example. Then you need to select the agent. By default, you could use Home Assistant, but here we are using the OpenAI conversation agent. Then you click on Settings. On the top, this is your prompt. The second line is the engine you will be using, the model. So I will use GPT-4. So you just type GPT-4. Token is the maximum size of the answer. So obviously, the longer will be the answer, the slower it will be, and the more expensive it will be. But it's only a few cents per answer, maybe like, I guess, 1 or 1 to 5 cents, maybe less. And on your prompt, you could modify it. This is basically list your devices. And I will write something here. So make short answers. And I will tell him that your answer will be read out loud using text-to-speech. So you should avoid special characters such as like, dash or whatever, because they could not be read out loud. So this is, of course, optional. Click on Finish. Then you need to put the speech-to-text engine. So here we are using the Home Assistant Cloud engine. This is the cloud services. You have 1 month for free. If you are running the engine on a Raspberry Pi, this is basically your only option, because otherwise it will be too slow. But if you are using a virtual machine on a large machine with a lot of RAM, of course you could do it locally. Same, this is a then you have the text to speech. I choose the default voice. Still using the Home Assistant Cloud. It could be done locally too. But for the simplicity of this video, I will just use the Cloud Assistant service. And one of the most important thing is a wake word. Oh, I forgot, you need to install the Open Wake Word extension. So you will go back on Settings and search for Open Wake Word. Here I'm just setting the most obvious one, the first one called Hey Jarvis. So each time I would say Hey Jarvis, it will trigger the wake word. So then I need to click on the little star here to be the assistant by default, or I should say the pipeline by default. And I click on Update. And then on the other view, I should see RaspiAudio Muse Luxe now. And here is a demonstration. Hey Jarvis, please invent a bedtime story for my kids involving a rabbit and a turtle.
Once upon a time, in a peaceful forest, there lived a lively rabbit named Hoppy and a wise old turtle named Slow-Mo. Despite their differences, Hoppy and Slow-Mo were the best of friends. One sunny day, they decided to have a race to the big oak tree at the other end of the forest. Hoppy, being the fast runner, was confident that he would win. Slow-Mo, on the other hand, knew he was not as fast, but was determined to try his best. The race began, and Hoppy sprinted ahead, leaving Slow-Mo behind. Halfway through, Hoppy decided to rest under a tree, sure that Slow-Mo was far behind. While Hoppy was sleeping,